Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for attending this year's commission debate for Group 4. My name is Renee Hancock, student body president at Newberry High School, and I will be your lead moderator. Over there, to my left, is my vice president and co-moderator, Connor Cannell. What will be on my right is the junior class president, Maria De La Cruz. She will be keeping time for us this evening. In the back, at the table, is Corey Walker and Scarlett McDonald. They will be taking care of questions that you may have during the debate. If you have a question, raise your hand and she will come to you with a note card and a pen for you to write your question down. We will do our best to get through as many questions as possible that the time allows for. Student government would like to say a special thank you for the participation of the candidates, city employees, and Mr. Marlowe for helping make this debate possible. I would like to remind all of you that this debate will be live streamed tonight on YouTube. Tonight's debate will consist of 4 pre-composed sections, and we'll have 3 times for questions from the audience to be read. We do have a few rules for the night, however. For each response, candidates will have 2 minutes to respond. If another candidate is mentioned in their response, that candidate will have a chance to rebuttal for approximately 30 seconds. We ask the audience to please give each candidate an equal chance to answer their questions uninterrupted. And again, if you have a question that you would like either all of the candidates or just one specifically, simply raise your hand. Thank you, and we will begin momentarily. Candidates, for your response, you will have 2 minutes. You have been seated in alphabetical order. We will begin the questions in that order and will cascade through the debate. A green card will be raised when you first begin to reassure that your time has started. At the 30-second mark, Ms. De La Cruz will hold up a yellow card. When you are out of time, she will hold up a red card. We ask for you to respect the audience's time and do your best to adhere to the time limits. Is everyone ready? We will begin with Mr. Romero for your 2-minute opening statement. You can start when you're ready.
Good evening, everyone, residents, fellow commissioners and candidates, student body government. Thank you for hosting this event. Mr. Marlowe, thank you for organizing the event, and my thanks to the city for allowing us to use the facilities here for this event. My name's David Amerio. I was moved here in 2009 from Pinellas County, Florida. I came up to Newberry because I thought that the community looked like a nice community to come to. I also have family here. After moving here, we built our first house, and I'm now raising my family here. I'd like to see the city of Newberry expand economically. From where we are right now, the city is growing residentially, but we haven't seen the business service growth that I feel that the city requires for the residents to be able to experience things, entertainment, food, services like medical, things of that nature. So one of my goals as candidate is to open discussions with businesses that are looking to move to the North Central Florida area and help them see the city of Newberry as a destination to bring their businesses. Thank you.
Thank you. Ms. Hassan?
Good evening to everyone, and we just thank you for organizing this debate for today and giving us the opportunity to come out and share with the community the things that we have in mind. I am a resident of Newberry, and I have been for the majority of my life. I was actually born in the family home in Newberry with the assistance of a midwife and Dr. Corrales, for those that remember him. He'd see me about and call me his baby. So that's how long I've been. I started out actually in as a Vista volunteer when I was just kind of coming out of school and not really sure what I wanted to really pursue. And I thought I was going to South America, but what they did, they reassigned me to my community, and we started, a team of 3 of us started working, establishing community-based organizations, and I just got into it and I loved it, and I've been working in the community for approximately 46 years. I've served on several different boards here in the city, the Cemetery Committee, the Utilities Assistance Committee, the Citizens Advisory Committee, and have worked on various projects over the years. I am the daughter of Freddie Womack, who was the first and only black mayor of Newberry, Florida. I was raised by Maxie and Eugenia Perkins. Maxie Perkins worked for the city of Newberry for 24 years and at one point was a commissioner. And we just have a history in my family of working with the citizens here. And I love the community, and I like to have the opportunity to serve with compassion to all the people that's here. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Hassan. Commissioner Martin.
Excuse me. Thank you for tuning in tonight, whether it's here in person. There are a lot of great faces here in the audience, and that's wonderful. Hope some folks are taking advantage of the YouTube channel that we've just kind of gotten started. And if you can't see tonight, maybe catching us later on. But I certainly sincerely appreciate the honor of being able to serve as a city commissioner for the last 4 years. I look forward to continuing to do so in the upcoming 2 years with the support of the community. I think a few just bullet points I want people to understand and maybe just catch on tonight is we had quite a few things that we were challenged with 4 years ago when I was elected. I've been very privileged to be a part of helping fix some of those things. And I would encourage the number of people that we have in our community that are new to get with some of the citizens who have been around for a little while and see how things have changed actually over the last few years and what kind of a positive direction that we are going right now. We have a great opportunity here to earn your trust and your vote. We stand on the shoulders, I've said it many times before, we stand on the shoulders of a lot of great people in this community, Judy's father being one of them for sure. And I'd like to, as our motto says, embrace the past and look forward to the future and just keep continuing to do what we're doing. The first 2 years of my tenure, I think we tried to get a few things corrected and fixed. I think the last 2 years we have been able to dial that in. And I think our biggest challenge, as I said last night, is really trying to get the most out of what we have done over the last couple of years to make sure that we continue doing and going in what I feel is the right direction. Hopefully, folks that support me feel we are going in the right direction as well. Thank you.
Thank you, Commissioner Martin. Mr. Mungin.
Well, first and foremost, thank you guys for all coming out here. We really appreciate it. Got a good little group here, and of course thank you for all the ones on YouTube watching us right now as we're doing this, and future ones that are watching later. I moved to Newberry in 2010, roughly in that area, and I came to Newberry, tried to further my education at the University of Florida, graduated there in 2012, and I decided to stay here in Florida and stay in Newberry to, I guess, kind of grow my roots. I always tried to be small town kind of guy. My bringing up was up in Vermont, is where I was born and raised, and I just kind of like that feeling, you know, the everybody knowing everybody, you know, and this town offers that, and so that's why we decided to stay here. I also decided to take a job with the Newberry High School to help coach. I coached the Newberry golf team and the Newberry baseball program, and I also substitute teach there. So that is one of my biggest passions I have is teaching the youth and being there and trying to be a role model for them and trying to kind of guide them, get them in the right direction in life, you know, trying to give them a helping hand. One of the things that I want to see out of Newberry is a little bit more economic growth, commercial side. We certainly have enough residents building a lot of homes in Newberry. That's great. But we need to also build businesses as well. And another passion of mine is kind of the beautification of downtown. You know, going through some of the other local towns, you know, their downtowns have that picturesque look. And I think we're in the right direction with Newberry Main Street. And I think we can, you know, certainly maybe take it a little bit further, I guess, and encourage or help and get more volunteers. Those are two of my biggest concerns right now. Thank you.
And thank you. We will be moving on to our first section tonight. This is the budgetary and economic questions. As I've explained to the candidates earlier today, we are going to start with Mr. Mario and be working our way down the row to where each candidate will be able to answer all four of these questions that will be asked. The first question tonight, or statement. Briefly summarize your strategic plans for economic development within the city of Newberry for the next 5 years. Mr. Mario.
Where we are right now in an economic plan is we're in a process of righting the ship. Mr. Barden, my colleague here, has done an excellent job of working in that regard. But our long-term goals haven't really been set at this point for economic growth, as well as taking care of the residents from recreational standpoints, from beautification of downtown, things of that nature. They've righted the ship. We're back in the positive. We're paying down our debts. Now we need to start to focus on getting different services and attracting things to this area to help us grow that so that we can continue to move forward. One of the things that I'd like to do is again, go out and find businesses, find entities that are looking to move into North Central Florida, and sit down and talk to them, present to them why Newberry is a great place to set up shop, so to speak. One of the problems I think we've had is positioning the city of Newberry as a great place to come to. Right now, people kind of fly over Newberry when they're coming from Gilchrist County, from Levy County, going into Alachua County, into Gainesville and stuff. They don't see Newberry. They just drive through. So we need to work on a plan, and I would work with the rest of the commissioners in an idea to try to attract businesses to the area, try to attract further businesses here to prevent that flyover. And that's going to help us in turn drive some more budget that we need to do other fun stuff that we'd like to do with the city and grow.
Thank you. Mrs. Hahn?
A future plan in place to facilitate economic development. Myself personally, I would like to see more jobs. I'd like to see our town become more attractive, more active, that we have more activities, structured activities for all age groups, that's seniors and our youth and our adults and everybody, that just we can just come out and make the place beautiful, make it attractive, attract companies, do what we need to do to get some people in here. We have a lot of homes being built, but we need jobs, because currently what people are doing, they are leaving Newberry to go somewhere else and spend their money. And we'd like for them to spend it here to help our economy, give us an economy boost. I actually heard a story of a man that lives within the city limits of Newberry in an annexed area that has been living in the area for approximately 10 years, and he's never been downtown in Newberry. Those type of situations we need to look at and put some things in place that we can attract people to our city.
Thank you. Before we move on, I would just like to say that we are having some technical issues when it comes to streaming on YouTube, but we are going to try and resolve that as quickly as possible. Commissioner Martin?
Sure, thank you. We have been able to pay down over $1 million of debt. We have reduced taxes by close to 10%. We maintain close to a $750,000 recreation budget currently. We have many initiatives as far as possibly segmenting parks to focus on certain age groups of people, adults to young children. I think what folks can expect from me is a continued focus on those types of things. A lot of what has already been said is a little bit out of the control of the city government itself. Our charge is not to create jobs. Our charge is to create the environment for those to happen through the marketplace, in my opinion. And it took a number of years to even get to the point where we can even begin to offer those types of things. You know, focusing on the infrastructure and getting some things fixed with regards to that all levels out the environment for those types of things to happen. They don't happen overnight, and it takes time to do those. I think Newberry is probably in the best position that they could have ever been currently to anticipate any types of business. We have changed zoning to accommodate business. We have, like I said, fixed the infrastructure. And to be able to go to a business and say, hey, we've created this environment, I think is a very good feather in our cap. I'm very proud of what we have been able to accomplish and look forward to doing that more.
Thank you. I would just like to announce that we are up and running when it comes to streaming live. Mr. Munden?
Convenient that it was off when you were talking. Now it's on when I'm talking. Great. Thanks. Wonderful. All right. Well, I would agree with a lot of things that David said about the economic growth. We need to certainly get more businesses in Newberry, without a doubt. And one of the things that I would, one of the things I would like to see, I mean, you have to have a good-looking downtown. And I know Main Street, Newberry Main Street, has done a wonderful job. And I know in the budget that the city has, we have money that we can put trees and things of that, you know, bushes and beautification things around in Newberry. And maybe that we could not take it completely from somewhere else, but somewhere that may not need it as much on the outskirts of Newberry, and put it more into downtown, make downtown look a little bit more picturesque. You know, either shorter bushes, shorter trees, bushes, something that people can see out of their business, people can see their businesses, you know, when they're advertising on their windows or what have you. So there's some things that we can do to make Newberry a more picturesque, more inviting place for commercial businesses, for, you know, economic growth, people coming in and wanting to start their business or even transfer their business to Newberry. I know that the commission has also either in the process of or is done or is going to do water and sewer expansion. That's also going to help down Newberry Road, so that's definitely a feather in their cap as well. So there are things that the commission is in the process of doing. We just need to continue that and maybe broaden it a little bit, maybe take a slightly different approach to try to get certainly more businesses in Newberry so we can help take some of the burden of the tax away from the citizens. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Mudgeon.
Our next question for the night is going to start with Ms. Hassan and move down the row. The question is, would you support budgetary investments for creating structured activities for all of the age groups in our community? Ms. Hassan, you may answer first.
Yes, ma'am. Turn this on. Yes, I would. I know that we have to be very careful when it comes to the budget. I have attended several of the budget workshops, and I know that it's a kind of tedious thing to work out the different areas and see where we're going to spend money and what we need to put aside and what we need to reserve and that type of stuff. But certainly I am for being in support of spending money towards enhancing programs for seniors, adults, and children throughout our community, through all our communities.
Thank you, Ms. Hassan. Commissioner Martin?
Sure. One tack that I've taken as a city commissioner is I try not to micromanage as much as possible. I think our responsibility as a commission is to serve as a board, and our city manager is kind of the CEO of our quote-unquote company. I try to reserve telling the rec department director, for instance, what to do with his money and with his budget. Every year when we go through the budget, there's a certain amount of feedback that we provide based on what feedback we get from citizens, quite frankly. And I know that Brad has done a good job of trying to bring about some level of sports activities and things for all ages. He's tried a cornhole league. Certainly the kids are more than well taken care of as far as different activities there. So those things have been tried, and I would like to see the citizens express a little bit more interest by their level of participation and things like that. I trust that Brad can make those decisions for his budget in his area, and just kind of let him try to do that. I do provide feedback when necessary, but like I said at the beginning, I try not to micromanage. I don't think that's necessarily our position sitting at the commission level.
Thank you, Commissioner Martin. Mr. Mungin?
Could you repeat that question, please?
Would you support budgetary investments for creating structured activities for all of the age groups in our community?
Well, I would certainly agree to look at it, right? I would, you know, as long as it's not something that's put a burden on the city, of course, I would definitely take a look at that and consider it. You know, we need activities for kids. We need activities for adults, for that matter. I would agree with, you know, Commissioner Martin. You know, it would be nice to get more adults outside the rec department to volunteer, to spend more time. I think the kids, if they see that, you know, that whether they see it consciously or subconsciously, I think that would make an impact on their lives, knowing that, okay, they're volunteering. This is something that I should probably do when I get older, what have you. So I would look at it. I would consider, certainly.
Thank you, Mr. Mungin.
Moving on to our third.
It's okay. So there's several moving parts to this question, and some contingencies that are in play with this type of scenario. You're asking a question of whether or not we would, you know, either allocate or ask for new funds from the residents to go into structuring recreational events for all ages. On the surface, absolutely, it sounds great. But, you know, we want to get everybody involved. This is where the moving parts come into play, though. You have to have the resident engagement for it. And then you have to have the resident buy-in, because ultimately that's going to come from their tax dollars. I don't necessarily like the idea of raising taxes to structure something that doesn't necessarily have a great participation rate at the moment. So the one thing that I would like to do is leverage social media, let people know that of the existing activities that we have already built up within the recreational budget that we have, within Brad's budget that he has, and see where that goes. If we start seeing a lot of buy-in at that point, then let's approach the residents that are participating in those programs and say, hey, would you like to see us expand these programs? How would you feel about it? Get it to a point where it becomes a ballot referendum type thing to expand that budget from a taxation perspective, because ultimately that's how that's going to go, is it's going to result in a raise in taxes. So that's where I am in it. I'm not patently going to shut it down, but I also want to see where we are in terms of participation to have that discussion. And I don't feel like where we are right now, we have the participation yet. Let's go ahead and leverage that so that people know that it what we have exists now, and then go from there. Thank you.
My apologies. Moving on to our third question. This question is a two-part question. I will ask all of you both parts, and if you need me to repeat any part of it, just let me know. We are going to be beginning with Commissioner Martin. Part one. What is your philosophy in the role of taxation on the citizens of Newberry? And two, what principles would you bring to the discussion of whether to vote yes or no on legislation that would bring forth taxes to Newberry citizens?
Can you repeat it one more time? You're talking about how I feel about taxes and what is my tipping point of whether or not to raise them?
So what is your philosophy of its role in Newberry, of the taxation role of Newberry, and then what principles do you bring to the discussion of whether or not to vote yes or no on tax legislation?
Okay, sure. The first word that comes to mind is value. I don't think that as a general rule people shy necessarily at taxes or even paying taxes, as long as, like when you go into a store and you purchase something, you get the value out of it. So that's number one. I think as far as what goes into my decisioning is, where does that value balance in that, as a government, we don't create money. We don't print money like the federal government. So we have to take it physically from somebody else to give it to another person. So that's a very big burden as far as I'm concerned, and one of the biggest things that we do is decide whether to take it from one person to give it to another. That's probably 90% of my decisioning and whether or not is ever going to be worth it. I think experience tells me that government is best when it gets out of the way. I think we have two great examples of that in Main Street and with the RC park. Government's out of the way, volunteers go in, they're raising money, they're in the black, they're doing great things. So I also look at what really is our proper role. And a lot of times it boils down to infrastructure type things, personal security and safety concerns. That's why we went to, that's why I wanted to go, and we went into the contract with the Sheriff's Department. That's why you see bricks going up over at the fire department. And that's why you see the infrastructure improvements that you have, and why we're going to be having an ambulance bay built out at the fire station.
Thank you. Mr. Mungin?
I would certainly agree with Commissioner Warren about the value. You know, if the taxes, if people could put a value on their taxes, on the reason why they're paying their taxes, then it's tangible. Then they can touch and feel and see, and they can hold it and hug it, whatever they have to do. They can embrace it. As far as the second part of the question, which was, one more time.
What principles would you bring to the discussion on whether or not to vote for legislation that would
Okay. Before, I hope, before we would ever have to do that, we would extinguish every option that we have, whether it be with grant money or other means of getting money that citizens have already put into the federal government or wherever for taxes. So we get the grant money back, which is money I've already spent, and we can use that in Newberry, so we wouldn't have to raise taxes for whatever we would need them for. So it would certainly extinguish that first. And it would be hard pressed to, you know, approach each and every one of you and look you in the face and say, well, gee, we did everything we could, sorry we have to raise your taxes, if we didn't do that. So, you know, as a role, as a commissioner, you know, I would certainly look at other avenues before I'd even consider raising anyone's taxes in Newberry. Thank you.
Thank you. Sir Mario?
I believe everybody's kind of on the same page here. Nobody likes to raise taxes on anybody. Nobody likes to have that discussion. The reality of it is government does have to do it from time to time for operating expenses and things like that to keep track and or to take care of things like infrastructure and personal security, law enforcement, fire, rescue, ambulatory, things of that nature. We also do it for some fun things, you know, like parks and recreation, libraries, school system, which the city of Newberry doesn't participate in that at that level. That's at the county level. But that's where taxation comes into play. That's kind of where I would like to stay from a policy perspective or an ideology perspective of only tax where we absolutely need to and where we have vast majority of agreement. One of the things that a lot of people are on board on right now is talking about moving towards parks and recreation, things of that nature. That's been something that I've heard a lot of on the campaign trail so far. And so posing that question to the residents in a formal manner, I think, would be the way that we would have to do it before I could vote yes or no on it. I don't like the idea of taking money from somebody else for anything other than what is absolute necessity and something that I can demonstrate to them a return on investment. Because that's what I feel it is at that point if we are taking money from them, is we're taking their money to invest on their behalf. So we have to show them a return on that.
Thank you. Ms. Hassan?
I believe that taxes come about because of needs or desires that people have. And we look around in our community and something may be really, really needed. And you put a priority on it. Something might be strongly desired. And you rate it on a scale, but in all instances, what I feel is that we should have input from the citizens. So before raising taxes or adding any increase to anything that we can or could do, I think we should get input from the citizens and see how they really feel about it, see what's necessary. You have to prioritize your issues. Is it health risky? Is it safety? Is it something that is going to benefit the entire community? Just one little section of town is just a broad base of things. So in keeping with that, depending on information, feedback, and data that you get from formal surveys, then a decision will be made on how to vote, because then I would be a voice of the people, and that's what I really want to be, a voice for the people.
Possibly the city of Newberry should pursue.
Thank you. Well, I wholeheartedly believe in grant money. I used grant money when I went to the University of Florida, even though I was a veteran in the military, and I did get a lot of my education paid for from the military, I used grant money. Grant money is money that we've already used, we've already spent, we've already dove into, we've already invested into. It's tax money that's been taken out, and it's sitting there. It's waiting to be used. If we don't use it, someone else will. So, I wholeheartedly believe that we need to use grant money, use that avenue, use that approach, first and foremost, before we do anything, because that's money that's, like I said, just sitting there and waiting to be used. If we don't use it, another community will use it, and they use it for something else. So, to help take the burden off the citizens of Newberry, we use grant money.
Mario?
Great thing about grant money is the residents already have felt the pinch. So if we go get that money, they're not going to feel the pinch of it. One of the big things that I would like to do as far as the aggression on going to get grant money, I think we should be very aggressive about it in going and exploring what grants are available. Now, there are some grants out there that come with a lot of strings. So we have to look at those strings that are attached to that grant money and have an understanding of how those strings will impact our residents. But I don't think we should patently shut down grant money. I think it's something that we should readily go after. on a very, very aggressive basis. This is, you know, a good example is the Wild Spaces Public Places money. That's grant money that I believe my colleague was a little slow on the vote to throw our hat in that ring. That money there is already taken from the residents, you know, in the form of taxes at the county level. So our job as city commission, I believe, is to get as much of that money back to our residents, because they've already paid it in. It's our duty to do that, get them as much of that money back and use it for things that are there.
Thank you. Ms. Hassan?
I think that we should aggressively seek grant money and get as much as we can.
That's it. Thank you, Ms. Hassan. Commissioner Martin?
I think grant money is probably a big difference of opinion between myself and the other three folks here. If the grant money is your only issue and you like grant money, I'm probably not your guy. I believe that grants are, yes, they're taxes that are taken from everybody. So as far as we're the only ones that receive the money is not true. What happens is every community is paying into those, and everybody has got their hand in somebody else's pocket. So if we're paying into the Gainesville City, where Gainesville City is paying into Alachua, Gainesville's paying into High Springs. What it effectively does is it raises taxes for everybody in the end because of the domino effect. And my approach is to not necessarily do what everybody else is doing, particularly when it's a bad idea, because, mind you, every step of the way, we are adding to the cost. We never get that money back. There's somebody at a government desk sitting there that costs money to the citizens. We don't ever get that money back. I suspect for every dollar that leaves this community in taxes, we get probably less than
our sheriff department contract is up for renewal. What percent increase is acceptable?
Honestly, none. At this point, you know, the MSTU, I think, that debate has become just a loggerhead, basically, between the city and the sheriff's department. The sheriff's department is bound by law to provide us services, regardless of whether or not we enter into the MSTU. The amount of services is, I think, where we're looking at the negotiation from. Realistically, from a residential, and I'm speaking purely anecdotally, right? I don't see those heightened services that we're supposedly paying for coming from the sheriff's department. So I personally don't like the idea of her being able, you know, the sheriff's department being able to raise our costs of coverage when she's mandated already by law to provide that service to us. I don't like the idea that they've held certain things like SRO over our head, you know, the school resource officers over our head, or heightened response times and things like that over our head, in an effort to pad her budget. So, to answer the question, nothing. I don't think it needs to be raised unless there is a really, really, really good reason for it to be raised at this point.
Thank you. Ms. Hassan?
Right now, I really don't know what the percentage rate is, so I couldn't really make a solid statement. I could look it up, research it, or whatever, but at this time, because I just don't know, I don't have the information on the percentage that we're already paying.
Thank you. Commissioner?
Sure. Quite frankly, I think the MSTU versus the contract has probably been one of the most creative things that our commission has really come up with and done over the last couple of years. My goal going into the contract idea was really to get another perspective of what to do and to get her to the table and do something else. I didn't like the idea that we did not have a seat at the negotiating table between herself and with the county commission. I didn't like the idea that the MSTU is basically a blank check to the county to fill in when they come up with an agreement with the sheriff. I think going to the contract took the power right to the people in its most pure form that we can possibly have. With regards to any kind of increase, I'm not in favor of any increase really at all. I don't believe that what we are paying is necessarily what we are getting at that point. But as the discussions went along, it was really kind of a step by step. I wanted to really effort to get one piece of the puzzle. That was, hey, let's get one contract under our belt. Let's get the process under our belt, and then we can start tweaking it. Because what really, we're paving new ground, and we don't really know what's going to potentially happen. But I think what we do moving forward is really have to take a hard look at what we are getting for our money. We are not entitled to SROs. We are not entitled to additional deputies as a city body. We are not entitled to crossing guards, as David and Mario had mentioned. We're not entitled to those things as a city body. Everybody's a county citizen. You're entitled to county citizen level sheriff's protection, not those additional things. Thank you.
Would you, Mr. Mario, like to just a clarification on stance? You're allotted 30 seconds.
Absolutely. So my stance on that, Tim, was the SRO, crossing guards, county coverage are entitlements because those are all county entities. At that point, the SRO is within a county school. We don't have a city school system. So a school resource officer, if they're going to provide it to other schools within the county, it seems to me that they would have to do that across the board at that point. They can't just single us out because our schools happen to be within city limits. Our crossing guards happen to be within city limits. I don't think that that's something that they should be able to do.
Thank you. Mr. Mungin?
No, there shouldn't be any type of increase at all. I wouldn't be in favor of an increase. I don't think we deserve to have an increase. I think that the level of coverage we get from the Sheriff's Department now is mediocre at best. I live in a area where there's a lot of stop signs. Actually, those aren't even considered stop signs. They're more of a suggestion for a lot of people. So no one's pulling anybody over. So quite frankly, we need a lot more for what we pay for. I don't think we should pay more. I think we should get more. And I think that would be a really big negotiating point on my behalf, because if you even look at City Newberry's Facebook page or any of the forum pages, that people are constantly talking about, this car is parked outside this person's house, it looks suspicious, this person did this. I mean, it is Newberry in the last month. It looks like Little Chicago. I mean, it's crazy. Thank goodness there's no shootings and murder. Thank goodness. But I mean, as far as the crime rate and the people being concerned, I mean, that's genuine. You know, that is absolutely genuine. My neighbor, literally across the street, came out to his vehicle one morning and the door was wide open, and he thought it was his wife. Well, his wife got in the vehicle and there was a sweatshirt. So did somebody just like take a nap in their vehicle overnight? I mean, so we obviously need to do something. So we need more instead of less.
Thank you.
for question two of the citizen questions. We're going to start with Mr. Mario. What are your feelings on House Bill 17 that is being proposed to the Florida legislature, and how would it impact Newberry's ability to attract and keep new and old businesses?
So I believe Ms. Hassan is...
And questions will be starting in the alphabetical order.
Okay.
Since there are only normally just a couple that we can manage to fit in.
Okay. My apologies. Sorry. House Bill 17 is, to be honest with you, I'm not 100% familiar on that House bill. Does anybody have a clarification on the actual title of the bill?
We don't have the clarification. We can ask this question at a later point, and the person who did send in this question is more than welcome to submit clarification on what House Bill 17 is. We can instead move to a different question that was submitted, and that question will be asked at a later point when clarification is received.
Thank you.
So the second question that we will be asking instead is...
What would be your plan for the wild spaces, public places, money, if elected?
So I came to that workshop, and I like some of the ideas of not getting into new business with that money. One of the things that becomes a challenge with grant money, we've talked a little bit about grant money, is that's a one-time drop type thing. So getting into new business and taking on new projects with that money, while we have existing infrastructure within our park system that needs work, is probably not the best thing to do. At this point in time, after reviewing the Wild Spaces Public Places workshop, I believe that we need to focus on our existing parks and work on those parks and bring them up to date. They're in need of some work. There's some bleachers that need work. There's some structures at several of the parks that need some work, and things like that. To go ahead and work within our existing programs and existing parks. That would be how I would go ahead and move with this money right now, is to work with our existing stuff and improving that.
Thank you. Ms. Hassan?
I sort of agree with David as far as fixing up what we already have, working on our existing parks. But if there are enough funds available, I think we could get into a couple of new projects. But again, I'm going to say what my philosophy is having citizen input. So I think that what we would do is have citizens make suggestions and say what they would like to see, because it's our town. So I'm always going to say citizen input, have some suggestions from everybody, and then sit down and see what we can do and how far the money can go from the suggestions we have.
Thank you, Ms. Hassan. Commissioner Martin?
Sure. The Wild Spaces Public Spaces money, we're talking about close to $2 million over the course of 8 years, none of which is guaranteed. So as you're sitting up here, it's important to keep that in mind. I am totally in favor of trying to focus that money on existing facilities and existing programs, and not getting into additional things that could potentially cost long term, and especially cost once that sunsets in 8 years.
I would probably agree with the majority of these guys as far as the expenditure of the money, refurbished parks, of course. And as Commissioner Martin has stated, it's $2 million over 8 years. That's a long time. 8 years, $2 million, refurbishing parks. It's probably going to go pretty quick. And with no guarantee of that money, not sure